Good afternoon to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. This is our first lecture on class 11, chapter 5. The name of the chapter 5 is Complex Number. So this chapter is very important for your examination point of view as well as for your competitive exams. If you are preparing yourself for your NDA as well as for JEE Mains and Advanced, so be ready, because at least one question in every competitive exam, either NDA or JEE Mains, one question must be put in your final exams as well as in your competitive exam from the complex number. And this chapter is very important if you want to go for higher educations, because this chapter becomes the base for your research topics also. But we have not to go beyond that range, because we are today in class 11th, so we have to deal according to level 11th standard. Our first topic is complex number. As the name indicates, that the chapter name is complex number. And what's a complex number? We have to deal. Firstly, I start from a number which is called a real number. So make a look here. Real number. So I'm trying to define the easiest language for a real number. You can define a number which is real number or a not by simply a definition of the real number. The simple definition is, if any square of a number is positive, it means the number is your real number. I again repeat the definition of the real number. What's the definition? It states, if you do square of any number and you get a positive result, it means that number is your real number. So keep it in mind, this language, it's very easy to define the number. Either this number is real number or not a real number. Make a look here. For example, 1. I am taking positive 2, and you have to check this number is real number or not. Now you have to do it square. So I am doing square. Square of positive 2 is result positive 4. It means we get a number positive. So it should be a real number. I am going to take another one example. Example 2, negative 2. If I am again going to square, square of negative 2 is also positive 4. It means we get again positive. So it means this is also a real number. Now I am taking another example. Positive 2, but in terms of square root of positive 2. Now apply scaling. If I do scaling of square root, what will be the answer? Positive. It means again we get the number is positive, so it should be a real number. Now please make a look here. I am going to take another example, square root of negative 2. You know, square root of negative number is not a real number. It's, as its definition, we already noted in our, according to our 10th standard. If we do square root of negative 2, then what will be the its result? Is negative 2. It means we get a result negative. So this is not a real number. So these three are real numbers, but this is not a real number. So now the question arises, if it is not a real number, then what's the name of this number? So according to 10th level, the name of this number is not defined, and you have to store the answer if you get square of any number is negative. But according to your 11th standard, you can't store that this number is not a real number, because you have to study, if the number is not a real number, then it should be the number. That number is called a imaginary number. What we called it? Imaginary number. So it is not a real number, so it is a another number which is called imaginary number. It is basically represented by small letter IL. Imaginary number. And real number is represented by a small letter RE. RE stands for real number and IL stands for imaginary number. So if you get a squaring of any number is negative, then its number is a imaginary number. So the main question arises, why we are dealing imaginary number? Because according to 10th level, no question arises. We have to stop the solution, but now we have to find the solution. So what's the need of to define the imaginary number? What its needs? For example, if we have to solve, question is not solve x square minus 4 is equal to 0. It means we have to get the values for x on which the equation satisfy x square minus 4 is equal to 0. So we can get the values for this x. What's the values of x is? X square is equal to 4. And what's the value of x is plus minus, so it means x can either be positive 2 or x can either be negative 2. Both the values for the x satisfy the equation. So these are the two solutions of the this desired equation. Our next question is solve x square minus 4 is equal to 0. X square is equal to negative 4. Now scaling of a number is negative, so we cannot define, because this number is not a real number. Because square of any number is negative, it means it is not a real number. So its number would be a imaginary number. So in such type of situation, we have to define the number. So we have to extend the range of the numbers. Firstly, we have real number. Now we have increased this range and we get another number, and the another number name is called imaginary numbers. So to get the solution of these equations, we have to understand the imaginary number. That's the solution of this equations. So I hope you understanding this concept. So please make a note first, then I will proceed to our imaginary number. Now we have to define the imaginary number, or to represent the imaginary number, we have to use a symbol which is called iota. Iota symbol is represented by small letter I, and we called it as iota, I-O-T-A. It's a name of the symbol iota, and it has a predefined value. Iota is square root of negative 1. So you have to keep in this mind. The iota has a value of square root of negative 1. And we have to calculate the degree, or you can consider different power of x. Now question arises, how we get different powers of iota? If we have to given iotas, not single iota, iota's power, iota 100, iota 200, then how we calculate these power of iota? So we have to keep in mind some points. After that, you can calculate any power of the iota very quickly. Firstly, if iota is negative 1, square root of negative 1. And I have to find out the values of iota square. It means we have to do squaring on both sides. We will got the values of minus 1. So if we get the values, iota square is negative 1. If I have to got the values of iota cube, it means we have to find out the values of iota cube. Then I can simply write as iota square into iota. And what's the values of iota square is? Iota square is minus 1. And into iota, so we get minus iota. Keep in mind, if you get iota, then you can stop the answer. But if you get the power of iota is greater than 1, then you have to do simplifications. Now, if we have iota 4, what's the, how we can write it? Iota square, all square. So I can write as iota square, square. So iota square value is negative 1, and negative 1 square is get positive 1. It means we get 1. So in this manner we can calculate. So we have to find out a shortcut method to calculate the any power of the iota. So you have to keep it in mind 4 points. After that 4 points is sufficient to solve any power of iota. First point is you have to write iota as iota, and if you get iota square, simply write as minus 1, and iota 2 simply write as minus iota, and iota 4 is write as 1. This is very simple. You have to keep it in mind. It's very very important, because if you know these values, you can calculate any power of the iota. How we calculate different power of x, please make a note first, then I give some question and how we solve this. We have got the solution in few seconds. Now I write first question, exercise 5.1. I am doing the questions of exercise 5.1 from the Admit Mathematics. You can also, if you are reading from your NCERT, then you can also start from your exercise 5.1. So I am taking our first question. First question is, evaluate the following. We already know how we represent a imaginary number. So look at these questions. These questions are not a real numbers. Why these are not the real numbers? Please make a look here. Here we get minus 2, square root of negative 9. It means if we do squaring, we get negative 9. So this number is not a real number. So how we represent this? So keep it in mind. Look at these terms. Minus 1 can be represented by iota square. So wherever you find negative, please replace by it iota square. How it is? This can be written as minus 9 means 9 multiplied by minus 1. We can write as similarly here. This is also written as 121 multiplied by minus 1. And minus 1 is represented by iota square. Again here I am represented 121 iota square, and it can also be written as 9 iota square means 3 iota square, and 120 iota square means 11 iota square, and these come out from the square root. We get 3 iota multiply 11 iota. Now multiply, number is multiplied with number and iota is multiplied with iota. So 3 into 11 we get 33, and iota into iota we get iota square, and again we get the values of iota square. Iota square is again minus 1, so we can replace it 33 negative 1. We get an answer of minus 33. This is our required answer. So I represent each step. You can do it fast. How we can do it fast? By minus 25 means 25 iota square, because we can write it negative as iota square. Similarly here we can represent it as 49 iota square. We have to reason iota square is negative 1, and 25 iota square we get 5 iota, and 49 iota square we get 7 iota. 5 into 7 35, iota into iota iota square.
It means 35 iota square negative 1, we get
minus 35. Now solve this. Again minus 16, which is represented by 16 into iota square plus 3 into negative 25, and negative 25 means 25 iota square plus root negative 36 means 36 iota square minus 3 negative 16 means 16 iota square. Simply negative sign is represented replaced by iota square. Now this becomes 4 iota, this becomes 5 iota, this becomes 6 iota, and this becomes 4 iota. Now solve this. 4 iota plus me 5 is 15 iota plus me 6 iota minus me 12 iota. Now 15 plus 4 19, 19 plus 6 25, and 25 minus 12 we get 13 iota. Please make a look first. I hope this will be clear to you, because in this we have to replace just negative sign is replaced by iota square. It's very easy to solve such a question. Now our second question is, what? Evaluate the following iota raised to the power 243, and this is first second question, second part, iota raised to the power negative 79. And how we solve if I get the iota's power greater than 4? The simplest rule is, firstly you have to divide by 4, whatever the power of the iota. Here the power of iota is 243, it means we have to divide 243 by 4. 4 6 24. If 3 is not divided, it means we get 60. Now we have to break this into two parts. First part is iota 4 and second part is iota. In this we have to write, please make a note here, iota raised to the power n is replaced by iota 4 into iota 8. Iota 4 raised to the power your quotient, and iota raised to the power your remainder. So in this case our quotient is 60, so I have replaced by 60, and remainder is 3, so I replaced by 3. And we know what's the value of iota 4. Iota 4 is 1, so we can simply replace by 1 raised to the power 60. And what is iota cube? Iota cube is minus iota. So this is 1 into minus iota. Our answer is minus iota. It's very simple. You have to follow this rule. It's very simple. Now our question is, iota raised to the power n, negative 79. But these properties are for the positive power. So we have to first make its sign positive, we have to take it in the denominator. So if we take it denominator, what's with the power? Iota raised to the power 79. Now the rule is same, we have to divide the power in by 4. 79 raised to the power, we have to divide by 4. 4 ones are 4, we get 39. 4 nines are 36, we get 3. Now we have to do same. 1 upon me, we have to write iota 4 into iota. What's the quotient is here? 19. What's the remainder is here? 3. Now again same, iota 4 is 2, is 1, 1 raised to the power 19, and iota cube is negative iota. So we get 1 upon me, 1 raised to the power 19 is 1, we get negative iota. Now keep it in mind, in all question based on complex number, you have not to stop the answer whenever you got iota's terms in the denominator. You have to remove the term of imaginary from the denominator. That's why you have to do always rationalization to remove the imaginary terms from the denominator. That's why I am taking
rationalization. Multiply 5 into 5. What I am doing? I am doing rationalization. Now 1 into iota is iota divided by negative sign is, can be represented above and below. I am representing above. Now iota into iota we get iota square. I am solving here. Please make a note. 1 into iota is iota and I am taking negative sign is here. Now iota into iota is iota square. Again negative iota, iota square is minus 1. So negative negative cancel out, we get positive iota. It means 1 upon mein negative iota can be represented by iota. 1 upon mein or negative 1 upon mein iota is basically iota. So I hope you understand this. I will take some more question of this type. So please make a note first. Now I am going to take some more example based on the iota's power. Look at this. 1 plus iota square plus iota 4 plus mean iota 6. The concept is same. You have to divide the power by 4 and make it in two parts. Iota power into iota quotient into remainder. You have to learn every time. But the rule is iota raised to the power n is written as iota 4 to the power quotient into iota raised to the power remainder, and this is your number. This is your simplest rule. Now same rule you have to apply on this. This is the basically small term, so we can directly evaluate. This is 1 plus iota square. The value of iota square is negative 1. Iota 4 value is positive 1. Now what's the value of iota 6? If we divide 6 by 4, we get quotient 1 and remainder 2. It means iota 6 can be represented by iota 4 into iota, where quotient is 1 and remainder is 2. So solve this. 1 minus 1 plus 1 plus iota 4 is 1, iota square is minus 1. And what will be the answer? 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1. It means all cancel out, we get a result 0. This is very very simple questions. Now doing these questions, in this we get 1 plus iota raised to the power and 10. If we divide 10 by divide by 4, but the quotient is 2 and remainder is also 2. So we can write it as iota 4 raised to the power into iota, quotient is 2, remainder is 2, because here 4 into 2 8 and 2 8 or 2 10. Now same here we have to do iota 4 raised to the power into iota. If we divide 4 by 100, we get 25. It means iota 4 raised to the power 25 and iota raised to the power 0. Now same to, if we divide by 4, we get 250. So iota 4 raised to the power 250 into iota power 0. Now solve this. What's the answer? 1 plus iota's value is 1, 1 square, and iota square value is negative 1, plus iota 4 value is 1, and the power of 0, the base having power 0, the result is 1. It means we get 1. This is again 1 raised to the power 250. This is again 1. We get 1, 1 into minus 1 plus 1 into 1 plus 1 into 1. It means 1 minus 1 plus 1 plus 1. So 1 minus 1 0, 1 plus 1 2. It means we get answer of 2. Please make a note.
Now our question is, now evaluate. I am giving a question which is not in your book. Iota raised to the power 101 plus iota raised to the power 102 plus iota raised to the power 103 plus iota raised to the power 104. Evaluate this. Please look at this question. This question is only 1 second question. Without pen you can do directly. What's the result? You have to keep it in mind here. Please make a look here. This is very important. If we add what we will get, iota minus 1 minus iota plus 1, it means 1 cancel out with 1, iota cancel out with iota, we get answer is 0. These are the continuously number, iota, iota square, iota cube, iota 4. It means whenever you find iota's power in continuous 4 number, then the result must be a 0. Here please note 101, 102, 103, 104 are 4 consecutive iota's power terms. So the result answer is 0. So please make a note this. If you find iota's power in consecutive integer power, in 4 consecutive integer power, then answer is 0. You can verify it. How we can verify it? I am verifying it. Iota raised to the power 101 plus iota raised to the power 102 plus iota raised to the power 103 plus iota raised to the power 104. 101 divided by 4, what we will put? 25 as a quotient and 1 as a remainder. So 25 as a, please make a note first, then I will prove myself. Now I am solving here. Iota raised to the power 101. The procedure is same, we have to divide by 4. If we divide 101 divide by 4, 4 to the 8, we get 21. 4 5 is a 20. It means we get a remainder 1. So we can write as iota 4 raised to the power 25 into iota raised to the power 1. Similarly, in this we can write 120 is iota raised to the power 25 into iota raised to the power 2, because whenever a raised to, we get remainder 2. Similar manner, if we know this, iota 4 raised to the power 25 into iota raised to the power 3 plus iota raised to the power 4, we divide by, we get 26 and the iota raised to the power 0. Now solve this. This is 1 into iota plus 1 into iota square, we get negative 1 plus 1. Iota cube is negative iota plus iota 4 is 1 into iota 0 is 1. So here we get iota, here we get negative iota, here we get negative iota, and this we get 1. So this one will be cancelled out, this iota this will be cancelled out, this we get answer is 0. So please make a note, if you find 4 consecutive powers and we have to find out its term, then the result will be 0. So this question is a 1 marks question. It becomes a concept. If you know the concept, then you easily crack your NDA as well as your JE main questions. So please make a note first, then we will proceed to our next question. So this is our next question, question number 3 from exercise 5.1. It's very easy to solve out. Please solve this. Iota 90 can be written as iota raised to the power 4. If we divide by 4, we get quotient 4 and remainder is 3. Now in this 1 and divide by iota, the whole power is 25, so we have to do separate power. We get 1 raised to the power 25 n iota raised to the power 25, the whole square. What will be the results? Iota 4 is 1 and iota cube is negative iota. Plus 1, iota 25 can also be written as 55 by 4 or 6 at 24. It means we get quotient 6 and remainder is 1. What will be the result? 1 into minus iota is minus iota plus 1 divided by iota 4 is 1 into iota. We got minus iota plus me 1 upon me iota, the whole raised to the power 2. Now if I take LCM, what will be the result? Iota minus iota square plus 1, the whole raised to the power 2. And this is, what's the value of iota square is? Negative 1 plus 1 divided by iota whole raised 2. Negative 1 negative becomes 1 and 1 plus 1 becomes 2. 2 by iota whole raised to the power 2. Now 2 square is 4 and we get here iota square. And what's the value of iota square is again negative 1. So we get minus 4. This is the desired result. So please make a note first. Now we have to find out equality of a complex number. This is our second topic. First topic is to find out the iota's power. Our second topic is we have to find the equality of a complex number. What it states? It states if two complex numbers are equal, then what's the condition? Let z1 is your x1. Firstly, I have to describe what is your complex number before it. Firstly, I have to describe a complex number because we read already read a real number as well as imaginary number. If any number that has both the parts, real number as well as imaginary number, that number is called your complex number. Now our question becomes based on complex number. What's the number? Again, I write. Complex number is equal to real number plus imaginary number is called your complex number. For example, most probably the complex number is represented by capital letter Z. Z is your real number. Suppose I represented X as a real number, and we know the imaginary number is always represented by a symbol iota. So we can write as iota 1. This is the standard notation of a complex number. Let's make a note here. Complex number is basically sum of a real number and imaginary number. So this is your real number and this is your imaginary number. How we can differentiate this one is real and this one is imaginary? Any number which is associated with iota symbol is called your imaginary number and other number is your real number. So in this case, x is our real number and iota y is imaginary number. But iota indicates the number is imaginary. And when I am talking only x and y, only x and y, only x and y are real number. Now iota y is your imaginary number. Please make a note here. X and y the real numbers, but when I iota is associated with y, it becomes an imaginary number. So real number plus imaginary number is called your complex number. Now the question comes here. What is the equality of a complex number? It means if we have two complex number, then what's the condition to be a complex number? I'm rubbing here this first is, let z1 is our first complex number. So I'm representing it by x1 plus me iota y1. And Z2, this one is your second complex number, which is represented by
एक्स टू प्लस में आयोटा वाई टू।
इफ दिस टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर आर इक्वल,
इट मीन्स इफ जेड वन इज इक्वल टू जेड टू, मीन्स एक्स वन प्लस में आयोटा वाई वन इज इक्वल टू आयो एक्स टू प्लस में आयोटा वाई टू।
इफ टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर आर इक्वल, इट इंडिकेट्स दैट रियल पार्ट्स मस्ट बी इक्वल टू रियल पार्ट्स एंड इमेजिनरी पार्ट मस्ट बी इक्वल टू इमेजिनरी पार्ट्स। इट इंप्लाइज x1 इज इक्वल टू x2 एंड इस मेथड ऑफ फर्स्ट, सो इट्स वेरी क्वाइट इजी। रियल पार्ट इज इक्वल टू रियल पार्ट, इट मीन्स x1 इज इक्वल टू x2 एंड इमेजिनरी पार्ट। अगेन आई रिपीट, आयोटा indicates the parts which is associated with is called imaginary, but we have not connect we have not take the iota symbol. So x1 is equal to x2 and what's the imaginary part? Here the imaginary part is y1 and here the imaginary part is y2. Iota basically indicate that this is a imaginary part but not indicate the value. So the value is the number which is connected with iota. That's why the imaginary number is here y1 and the imaginary number is here y2. So y1 is equal to y2. This is the concept to take the equality of a complex number. So it's very quite easy. Now we have to take our question. Find the values of x and y if this is equal to this. If you get an equal sign, it means we have to do equality of a complex number. So what we have to do? You have to do separate on one side real part and imaginary part, and the same you have to do on the right hand side. You have to separate real part and imaginary part. Now then compare real part is equal to real part and imaginary part is equal to imaginary part, and you get the solution of these results. And here this is your real part because iota is not connected with this, and here iota is connected to whole term. It means this is imaginary. Here this is your real and this one is your imaginary. So we have to do comparison or comparing. Real part is equal to real part and imaginary part to imaginary part. What's the real part in here? We get 4x. 4x is our real part. And what's the real part is here? Positive 3. So we get 3. So we get 4x is equal to 3. Then what's the value of x is? 3 by 4. Now we have to do same. What's the imaginary part is here? 3x minus y. And what's the imaginary part is here? Minus 6. Because if we remove the iota, we get minus 6. Iota indicates the imaginary part. So we get here minus 6. Now you have to put x values of x in here. 3 into 3 by 4 minus y is equal to minus 6. Now we have to solve this. 3 into 3, 9 by 4 minus y is equal to minus 6. I am solving here. I have to calculate the values of y. So that's why I have to take this on right hand side. And now take minus 6 on the left hand side. 9 by 4 plus 6. What's the LCM is? 4. 9 plus 6 fours are 24. So we get 24 plus 9 is 33. 33 by 4, which is equal to 1. So these are the values of x and y. Please make a note first. Our second part is 3y minus 2 plus iota 7 minus 2x is equal to 0. But please make a note here, on the right hand side, we not have a complex number. Please make a note here, 0 is also can be right in terms of a complex number. 0 basically indicates that the real part is also 0 and the imaginary part is also 0. Now we can write this 3y minus 2 plus iota 7 minus 2x. And 0 can be written as 0 plus iota 0. It means it has a real part is 0 as well as imaginary part is also 0. Now look at here. This is our real part and this is our imaginary part, because iota is connected with this number, so this becomes imaginary and there is no iota, so this becomes real. Now compare it, here real part is also 0 and imaginary part is also 0, so we comparing, if we do comparing, but we will got 3y minus 2 is equal to 0 and 7 minus 2x is again equal to 0. Now solve this. 3y is equal to 2, the values of y is equal to 2/3. Now here 7 is equal to x, so x is 7/2. Please make a note first, it's very quite easy, you have to do it yourself, it's very very easy. So our last question, the third, fourth question has four parts. So remaining two parts, we have to do it yourself because it's quite simple. Our next question is question number 5. Find the real values of x and y if this is equal to this number. And you please note it here. Here the real number and complex number are not separated because please make a note. This is iota, it means it contains also a real part and imaginary part. Here is also a real part and imaginary part. Keep it in mind whenever you get a symbol equal. So you make it left hand side as in form of real number plus imaginary number. And the same you have to do it on your right hand side. The same real part and imaginary part. You have to combine all the reals to make it single real and combine all the imaginary to get a single imaginary. So we have to do it here. So in this firstly we have to separate real parts and imaginary parts. How we do? Firstly multiply. Y square into 1, we get y square. Plus y square into iota, we get iota y square. Now multiply, we get 6 plus iota. This is our one side, and this is our right hand side. Now multiply 2 into x, we get 2x plus iota x. Now, what's the real part is here? Y plus 6. So you combine this y plus 6. This is your real part. And this is iota, it is also imaginary part, and here is also iota, it is also imaginary. So we have to take common, iota if we take common, but we will get y square plus 1. Keep it in mind, we have to combine real parts to make one real part and the all imaginary parts to combine one imaginary part. So that's why I am combining real parts as well as imaginary parts. So 2x plus iota x. Now we have to do the same step, comparing real parts, we have to compare with real parts and imaginary parts to compare imaginary parts. Now what's the real part is y plus 6, the real part is here 2x. Now compare real part is, or imaginary part is here y square plus 1 and imaginary part is here x. So we get two equations. So we can put or substitute one variable in terms of other variables. Suppose I have calculated y in terms of x. We have to take 6 on the right hand side. We get 2x minus 6. Now I am substituting this y in here. But we will got y square means 2x minus 6. Whole square plus 1 is equal to x. Now solve this, a minus b whole square, but we will got a square plus b square minus 2ab, 2 to the 4, 6 are 24 plus 1 is equal to x. Now solve this, 4x square, if we combine plus 36 and 1, we get 37 minus 24x minus x is equal to 0. We take negative x as the negative side. We get 4x square, 24 and 1, we get 25x plus 37 is equal to 0. Now you have to do factorization. Please do yourself. Please do it yourself. I think it becomes very complex. So do it again. We are substituting values of x in here.
to find out the balance of x here from here. The solution can becomes very small. We have to find out the value of x. What's the value of x is? Y plus 6 divided by 2, which is the value of x. Now put it here. Y square plus 1 is equal to y plus 6 divided by 2. We put the values of x here. Now do so. We multiply this 2y square plus 2, which is equal to what we will got. Please make a note first. Sorry, we are doing mistake here. What's the mistake is y square into 1. We get y square, but I am right y. So please make a note here. We get here y square. So in this we get y square plus 6 divided by 2. Y square plus 6. Now solve this. If we take y square on the left hand, we get y square. And if we take 2 on the right hand side, we get 6 minus 2, which is 4. The value of y is plus minus 2. Now we have to find out the values of x, and we know what's the values of x is. Y square plus 6 divided by 2. Whenever y is plus 2, put it here. 2 square is 4 plus 6 by 2. 10 divided by 2, we get 5. Then y is equal to minus 2. Again same, because minus 2 square plus 6 divided by 2. It means minus 2 square is 4 plus 6 divided by 2. 10 by 2. Again 5. It means we have got two solutions. First solution is x values is 2 and y values is 2. Second solution is x values is 2 and y values is minus 2. So these are the two solutions. So please do correction at this place. So this question becomes very easy. I hope you like my video. If you really like my video, so do subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. Then I will make our next video in our next class. So up to this we can do 3 and 4 questions. We already complete our exercise 5.1 according to Element Mathematics, and if you are doing NCERT, then you can able to do its 4 and 5 first questions, because in the NCERT only you get 2 exercise, but in Element Mathematics you get 4 exercise. So according to that, we cover our first exercise, then we will proceed to our next exercise 5.2. Thank you for watching my video from starting to end.